Sea lions actually swim differently than almost any animal. So fish are gonna swim back and forth and mammals up and down. Essentially they swim with like their feet or their fluke or their tail fin, but sea lions swim with their arms. So they use their foreflippers, but they're mammals, so it's like an arm, and they clap them into their body and form a jet. So it's really a very different paradigm of swimming than you'd find in any other aquatic mammal, any other really good swimmer. We've spent a lot of time using all the best technology we can, extracting their motion. So that's really been sort of phase one, is figuring out exactly what they're doing. So we take the data that we collect here, we take these images, and we look at the flipper at different angles. So we maybe take this angle, and we can digitize it and find certain points along the animal's foreflipper. And then what we do is we can go to the next frame and find those points again, and we're able to track the motion of the points from one frame to the next. So we can really mathematically describe that entire flapping motion. Been replicating that with a mechanical device. So sea lion flipper, like an arm, they have a shoulder joint, an elbow joint, a wrist joint. So we use that same three joint mechanism to create a robot that has three joints connected by bones and can then superimpose the motion from all of that observational film. And then finally we took some high resolution scans to really back out the geometry really accurately. And then we can use 3D printing and mold making to create an exoskeleton or a skin for our animal. We've just about got the prototype working.
Being able to work at the zoo is just such a fantastic experience because it gives an opportunity to work outside of the classroom, get real world experience, and really continue the scientific research that we're performing back at GW, but on site where all of it's taking place.
As humans, we've come up with a certain number of solutions to solve mechanical problems, and then they work, and so we stop thinking about it. But if you look at nature, nature has come up with an infinite number of solutions and always adding more as the evolutionary process progresses. And so what we try and do is to, let's look at nature and see how they're solving this problem and see if we can pick out really the essence of those solutions to design into the problems that we are trying to solve.